Welcome all of you again. If a particle is thrown from here with a velocity u and if it makes an angle alpha, now if you see from here, okay, if you see from, let us see from this point of view, what you will see? You will see this motion, okay, but if any observer, just try to think, this is our observer 1. If any observer is here at the point of projection and he is moving upwards up to this capital H, with a velocity u sin alpha, then what he will see? He will see, because he is moving with the particle at the same time when it reaches capital H, after that he again bounces back. Okay, he is the observer 2. Okay, there is another observer. Okay, let us take somehow the particle is somewhere here and this observer just on this particle. Now it is my observer 3. Okay, now it is my observer 3. He is moving with the same manner as that of the particle. This is my observer 3. Now my another observer is here, because we are now dealing with a reference frame. My another observer is here, observer 4. Here is my another observer, is observer 5. So what these 5 observers actually see? Okay, so if the observer is here, observer is somewhere outside of this reference frame, at that time he will see the trajectory like this, that is particle reaches here and again comes here. Okay, so he sees the full trajectory. That is trajectory like this. Just draw this. Okay, this is the by observer 1. For the observer 2, he is here. What he is done? He is just moving upwards with the velocity equal to u sin alpha. Okay, and reaches the height h, his velocity becomes 0, after he returns back. So what it basically is, it is nothing but the representing the vertical motion of the this projectile. So what he actually see, at each and every time he will see only one thing, that is the u cos alpha, that he will see the motion of u cos alpha. That is the particle is moving. With a velocity u cos alpha from here to here. Okay, so from here to here. So which type of motion he will observe? All the time he will see the particle is moving away from him. When he is here, the particle is moving away. When he is here, particle is moved away. When he is here, particle is here. When he is here, particle is here. When he is here, particle is here. All the time you will see the particle is moving away from him. Okay, now if I consider the observer of 3, observer 3, who is he? He is here. He is on the particle, or he is moving with the same velocity as that of the particle. And what we will see? He will see the particle is at rest. Particle is straight with respect to him. There is no relative velocity between them, so he is completely rest. Okay, now for the observer 4. What the observer 4 sees? Observer 4 sees the particle coming like here. Particle approaches towards him, then again move away from him. Particle approaches towards him and again move away from him. So he will see something like this. He will be here. Now for the observer 5, what you will see? The particle is projected from here. It just like comes. So what you will see? You will see the this type of motion. Okay, he is here. Observer 5 is here. He will see this type of motion. So for each different observer, the observer's point of view, the projectile motion is different. But what we see from the point of view of all the time, from the point of view of observer 1. Okay, now after saying all of these things, my observer, in the next case, I want to say the observer is here. This is the x-axis and y-axis. The observer is, this is the project trajectory from for the observer 1. Now my observer is sit at this position with some chair or tool, whatever be it, he is sit at this position, and his height from here is small h. So he only sees this level. He only sees this level, yes or no? See, if he only sees this level, so from he see from here the vertical crosses this. Okay, vertical just moving upward, after that vertical is moving downward. Is it clear to you? And if he sees somewhere, he just scales up here, if he see here, if he see from here, then he will see the particle just comes to his level only for one time. That is for the maximum height. But since he is less than that of the maximum height, since his height is less than that of the maximum height, so we can say he sees first time, let us say it is a time t1, and the particle moves up, and when time is t2, see the particle is moves down. Okay, so this is the thing. Let us take some values, okay, some numerical values. Let us take this h, small h equal to 9.8 meter. So he is, this observer is at a height 9.8 meter, and this particle which is thrown from here, okay, that is the u. Particle which is thrown from here, its velocity is 29.4 meter, and this u makes an angle 30 degree with the horizon. So after which time, what is the time interval between this, he will see this particle moving upward and downward. That is my point of interest. So if I want to find out the u sine theta, the component along the y-axis which is responsible for the vertical motion, then it will be meter per second. It will be 29.4, it is sine 30 degree. Sine 30 degree, so it will be approximately 14.7 meter per second. So this is the thing. So if I want to write down this thing, then it will be 9.8. What is 9.8? 9.8 is basically the h. If I write down the equation motion first, then h equal to u y into t plus half of minus of g into t square. Okay, h is measured along the positive y axis, so positive. U y is measured along the positive y axis, so positive. And a is measured along the negative y axis, so it is negative. So it is 9.8. What is u y? U y is 14.7 t plus 1/2. G is minus 9.8 into t square. So if I want to write down this thing, then it will be a quadratic equation of motion of time. So if I solve this thing, then it will have two roots or two values of time. So if I slightly try to arrange this thing, it will be 4.9 into t square, it is minus 14.7, it is 9.8, and it equal to 0. So if I just divide this thing, then it will be t square minus of, sorry, here is a t, minus of 3t and it is here 9.8, so it will be 2. I just divide by 4.9. So it is a quadratic equation, and if I do the middle term factorization, you know it is t minus 1 into t minus 2. So both these values are possible because the time is here 1 second, time is here 1 second and 2 second. So when it crosses this one, at that time the time is 1 second. And when it crosses this thing, this level again, after that it reaches the maximum height and again comes to this level, at that time t equal to 2 second. Okay, so just like this. So this observer sees this. After this projection, after one second he sees this, it is moving upward. Then it reaches the maximum value, and again it just crosses his level after 2 seconds. So what is the time difference between these two levels? That is 1 second. If I want to calculate time difference, that is 1 second. So after 1 second, he will see the object again coming down. The equation of a projectile. Equation of a projectile is this. Obviously, it is the equation of a projectile. It can be understood that it is the of the form of ax minus bx square. So, if it is ax minus of bx square, from here you have to find out the maximum height, that is what is the value of capital H and what is the range here. Okay, so obviously you know that y equal to ax minus of b x square. Okay, so what is a? A is tan theta or angle of projection, or tan alpha, theta or alpha, whatever be the angle of projection, and b gives us g divided by 2 u square cos alpha, cos square alpha. Okay, so this is the thing. So from here you have to find out the h. Okay, so if a is 1 here, so tan alpha is 1 here, so from here we can see that the alpha is 45 degree. Alpha is 45 degree here, and from here if I put this cos 45 degree value here, then it will be g it is, and 2 u square. What is the value of cos alpha? Cos alpha value is cos 45 degrees 1 by root 2, so cos square alpha is 1 by 2, so it will be g divided by u square. Okay, so b is 1 divided by 100 equal to g by u square. So from here we can find it out that u square equal to, if I consider g is approximately 10, then it will be 1000. So u equal to root over of 1000, so it will be 10 root over of 10 meter per second. Okay, so this is the thing. If I obtain this thing, then we can find the h equal to u square sin square alpha divided by 2g. So u is 10 root 2, so we can say it is u square is 1000. I put 1000 here. Alpha is 45 degrees, sin square 45 degrees 1 by 2, so it will be 1 by 2. It is 2 and it is 10. So if these things cancels out from here, 0 and 0 cancels out, then it will be 1 by 4, then h is 25 meter. The height is 25 meter. If I want to calculate the range from here, range is u square sine 2 alpha divided by g. So the u square is 1000. Sine 2 alpha is sine 90 degree. Alpha is 45 degree. So sine 2 alpha is sine 90 degree, that is 1. And g is 10 here, so it will be 100 meter. Okay, but this thing is a completely slightly bit of Pythagoras method. But if I apply my concepts here, then how it will be find out? That it be an alternative treatment. That is, why what this y actually says us. Y is the vertical, y-axis, x-axis. This is the motion. So y is the vertical motions, and when this vertical motion is maximum, okay, when this vertical motion, that is dy dx, is maximum, and then we get the maximum height. Okay, so we try to find out this thing. So if I calculate this dy dx here, it will be 1 minus 2x by 100. So x equal to 50 meter. So for the value of x equal to 50 meter, y is maximum. So if I put it here, so it will be 50 divided minus of 50 square divided by 100. So 50 square, we can write down this thing, 50 minus of 2500 divided by 100. So it will be 25 meter. It will be 25 meter. Okay. So if I want to find out the range, that is when this thing will be, x will be maximum. But there is another way of solving. When this y will be 0, that is the vertical height will be 0, that will give us the range. So if I put the vertical height is 0, that is the y is 0, at that time it will become x minus of x square divided by 100. Okay, so from it we can easily calculate x equal to x square divided by 100. X cancels out, so from it x equal to 100 meter. That is, it is the basically tells us the range, and it basically tells us the maximum height. We need not to think about the equations, that is a x minus b x square, what is the value of a and what is the value of b. We need not to do that. We need not to do this, all of these calculations, and again after finding out the value we have to again put these things. We need not to do this. The thing is that what we have done here, just applying our concept, that is when this y will be maximum, then we find out the value, that x equal to 50, this y will be maximum. Okay, then the x value of x equal to 50, this y will be maximum. This value of y will be maximum, then we find out the value, put the value of x in that equation, we get the value 25 meter. Okay, and that gives the value of maximum height. I again apply my concepts, that after the motion, after this motion, when this particle again returns back to the ground or the horizontal level again, at that time y will be 0. If y will be 0, then we have just find out, put the y equal to 0, then find out the x equal to 100 meter, and that gives us the range. Okay, that gives us the range of the particle. So this is the thing. We have seen that when the acceleration due to gravity is perpendicular to that of the instantaneous velocity of the particle on the trajectory. Now my question is that if a particle is thrown from here and it reaches here, okay, my question is, if its initial velocity is u, then for what value of v it will be perpendicular to the initial velocity. So if I say it is this, and if I draw it is 90 degree, it is perpendicular. If I just try to draw this tangent, it will touch somewhere here. Okay, so this value of v, that is that this value of v, we want to know the value of v for which it will be equal perpendicular to that of initial velocity. Let us consider it is thrown at an angle theta. If it is theta, then this will be theta. Okay, if it is theta, then just see, it will be v sine theta. Okay, and it will be v cos theta, and this thing is equal to, and this portion is equal to u cos theta. This u cos theta and v sin theta, we know that the horizontal velocities are equal. If the horizontal velocities are equal, then u cos theta equal to v sin theta. Okay, then if I want to find out the value of v, for which the initial velocity is perpendicular to that of the value of v, for the initial velocity perpendicular to that of it. Okay, that will be u cos theta. So it's some kind of tactical answer. Sometimes tactically we have to answer this thing. Thank you.